Hey, it's John and Enduring Charm. So this is a septic access cover, and this particular septic tank I actually did a video on some years ago, and it's time for another cleaning. So yesterday I did dig this out. I can show you some footage of that. Don't need a coat now, plenty warm. So with this dug out now, it's not that deep. This is maybe, I don't know, a foot and a half, maybe almost 2 feet. And you'll see there's a handle here and a handle here, and the pipe is off the center. So this is basically ready for the fellow to come pump it out. He'll give me a hand getting these handles attached to a chain, and we'll just yank this cover off. Now, there is one thing that's bothering me. I'm not sure how well this will come off on camera, but there is a crack right here and another one starting right there, which I'm not thrilled about. So I want to look at that to see how deep it goes, and this may be a cover that it's time to replace. So I've decided to install a riser on this system here. The cracks were one problem, and of course a riser will make it easier to get access in the future. Now, there's two methods you might choose. One is to have a riser that comes above the surface and therefore will show. But in this case, I prefer not to do that, so we'll have the riser just below the surface. Now, before I get too much further, I want you to understand that you may have local regulations about this, so, you know, don't take my word for it. Check with your local people there. It might be a town or a county or whatever. Just make sure you can do what you want to do. But in this case, I'm going to be using a riser system made by a company called Tuftite, and that company has a whole system here. Pretty simple in concept and in installation, and this is what I'm going to be using. So basically the most basic form of this is you need this adapter which will attach to the concrete tank. Then you have a riser. In this case I got a 6-inch riser. They also make a 12-inch riser, and you can stack those higher and higher depending on what you need. And then you have a cover which can be flat or domed. My cover will be below the surface here, so I chose the domed one just to let water run off of it. And then these will screw together so that they're, you know, firmly ensconced in there and will form a watertight seal. Now, in my case, I also picked a fourth component here. This really has a separate purpose, but we're going to use this really just to add an additional height to the whole system here. It adds like another 3 inches. So for me, I'll have a 6-inch and a 3-inch on top of this adapter plate here. And that should be enough to get me where I need to be. Now, installing this really couldn't be much simpler. This adapter will go on top of the concrete. And there's two methods you could use to attach this. One is butyl tape, which I did purchase, and that would go around the edge here. It's a self-stick kind of thing, and it's sticky on both sides, so it'll stick to the flange and stick to the concrete. Needless to say, the concrete has to be cleaned off. Or another method would be to use an adhesive sealant here, which would smear all over this and then, you know, put it down as well. You may choose also to do a mechanical fastener, which I probably will do. I'm going to look at that. So you could go through the top here using Tapcon screws and, you know, attach this mechanically as well. But either way, you need some way to seal this to the concrete. Otherwise, you could have gas escaping and you don't want that. So this gets attached to the tank. Then you'll install the riser or risers, whatever the size is. And this is designed to fit, you know, directly into this adapter here. So it just drops in, and then I'm going to turn this over. You can see there's a recess right here which fits into the adapter. Now I will put, there's nothing in this particular one, but I will put some silicone sealer in there. So again, I don't want gas escaping from this. So I'll seal that off. Then we'll drop this on top of the adapter. And then for me, I will have this additional piece right here which I can put on top or below. It doesn't really matter. But I'm just leaving this out of the equation for the moment. So normally you'd have this, then this. They do line up, if I find the right spot here, so that you can put screws in from the top here into the bottom here. So they are mechanically fastened together in a number of different spots across here. And then the last piece would be the top. And if you look at this top, the recess has like a foam gasket in there. So this is a reusable kind of thing. So that foam gasket will seal out the gases. And when I put this on top, again, if I get it lined up right, there will be stainless steel screws that go from here into the riser. So this will be mechanically fastened. But when I need to do a pump out, you just take the cover off by unscrewing those stainless screws. Cover pops right off. They can do their work, and then you put it back on later. So it's a pretty simple system, but as you can imagine, one thing that has to be done is to clean out the edges here. So when I put this down, you know, this all has to be clean of dirt, and I want to make sure I do a good job there because that has to seal well. The outside diameter of this adapter is 30 inches, but my cover is actually a little more than that. As you can see along the edge here, this adapter is going to end up fitting into that hole. Now that hole has a slanted side, okay? It's tapered. And that's the whole point of the concrete cover, is the concrete cover is also tapered and it fits into that taper and then seals itself. All right, I have the cover just partially off here. I have to wait for a helper to come to help me get this thing out, and I'll spare you what's inside here for now. So what I want to point out is that there's a kind of a double flange here. So there's the outside part that we were looking at before, which is really wider than this new adapter, but just below it, there's like a step in this area right here. And that step is where this flange is going to have to, or the adapter, I should say, is going to have to go. So I'm going to have a lot of cleaning. There's a lot of mud and stuff there, so I got to clean all this out, but I got to get this cover off first. I didn't feel like waiting, so I used an old trick here to get the top off alone. It's pretty heavy. So you can see here what I'm talking about. So that flange, that lower area right there, is where this new adapter is going to have to sit. So there's a lot of mud and crap in there, so to speak. So I need to clean all that out, and I'm going to have to use a hose to some degree, although I'll try not to use too much water, and we'll get all this cleaned up. All right, the butyl tape I'll use to seal the bottom there is a double-sided tape, and it's pretty thick, and it's smooshy. So this should do the trick. However, I may add some either silicone or construction adhesive to several areas where the concrete is kind of pitted and has some gaps and all. So I just want to make sure I'm covered. It won't hurt anything. And I don't think I'm going to need to use anything except this because the adapter is in that recess, so it really can't go anywhere. Okay, I've got the adapter in now, and that's situated pretty well. See how it fits nicely into that second step down. Now I'm going to start putting the risers on, and as I said, I'm going to take this recess right here, I'm going to fill it with silicone caulk, just so there's no air leaks. Okay, we got the risers in and all that's left is the top now. You see that white line around the outside there? That's just some additional silicone caulk I put in there just to keep it centered for now. Once I get the dirt in here, the dirt itself is going to hold it in place. But you know what? It's easy to do and it's cheap, so I just threw that in as well. And then I'll put the top on, which for now I'm not going to secure, but just to show you. It just sits like that. It's got the dome, so it will shed water. And this tank is due to get pumped out in a couple days, so I'm just going to leave it like this. But they have stainless steel screws which go on the top here, which will secure it once it's been pumped out. And then it's just a matter of putting dirt in here and covering this. So the top layer of dirt will be, I don't know, 4 to 6 inches. Just enough so you know, this doesn't show, but it's easy to get to in the future.
All right, with some dirt around the edges now, you can see how this is all going to work. I'm really pleased with it. It came out great, and it's just the right height. It's just enough below the surface where you can bury it, and maybe some very light plantings on top of it, something that doesn't go too deep. But basically, I'll probably just leave it alone and put some mulch over it. And then in the future, when I need to dig this up for another pumping, it'll be simple to get to, wipe off the dirt at the top, unscrew those screws, and the top will pop right off. So this is definitely something you could do for yourself. The cost is not that great, and it's really just a matter of digging down and cleaning things up. I'll try to put some links in the comment section so you can find this stuff for yourself.